Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Imam. I'm Hussein Baba. As you know, for the past 2 weeks, Imam has been discussing about information for new Muslims, right? And he's back here again. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Muhammad.
Assalamu alaikum, warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Welcome back. I'm good. Sheikh, is it becoming more interesting now? More interesting. Now, the can you continue? Because last time we talked about the love for Islam, yeah. The love for Allah, mm-hmm. And you're going to elaborate more on that?
Yes,
okay. Inshallah, let's see it.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad, al-Nabi al-Ummi al-Kareem, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa tabi'in wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Hajj, we need to do two things,
yes,
as we said before.
Right.
Number one,
yes,
to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
for, that's right,
this gift.
Yes.
Number two, to do everything just for Him.
Just for the sake of Allah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, not for just worldly things, not for people, just
right,
to see us and to say, oh, this one is good, this one is very good, and yes, this one. Just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right, yes.
When we do for Allah,
yes,
we will get our reward from Allah.
Allah, that's right. That's right.
Okay.
Yes.
When we do for people,
yes,
on the day of judgment, Allah will ask us to go to the same people to get our reward from them.
Which is impossible.
Yes, yeah, so impossible.
Impossible.
Everyone needs.
Yeah, everybody needs.
No one will give.
No one will give, that's right.
Okay.
So the only Almighty Allah,
yes,
can give you that.
Yes.
So when you're on earth, do for the pleasure of Allah.
That's
to
it.
Please Him.
That's
only.
It.
That's right.
That's
okay.
It. And for example,
yes,
we pray.
Yes.
Pray 5 times a day, alhamdulillah.
That's right.
To accept from us.
That's right.
But in our intention,
yes,
we should pray for Allah.
Of course.
I'm coming here to pray for Allah.
Yes.
Just to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be pleased with me.
Right.
Okay, this I'm doing.
Right.
And the same intention, we should use it for everything.
Everything.
When I pray.
Yes.
When I donate some money for the poor people, for masjid, for school, for something.
Right.
When I go to Hajj.
Right.
When I fast in the month of Ramadan.
Yes.
When I deal with my parents, with
right,
my neighbors, with
right,
the non-Muslim, with
right,
the, this one, that one, with my wife, with my family. When I do everything in my life,
yes,
we should put in my intention that I'm doing that just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
That's right.
On the day of judgment, so
yes,
this is called the ikhlas, sincerity.
Yes.
Sincerity,
right,
that means you're doing for Allah.
That's right.
On the day of judgment,
yeah,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will reward me.
Right.
Because in dunya, I used to do for
yes,
Him.
That's right. Yes.
For Him.
That's right.
On the day of judgment, He
yes,
will say, if you used to do for me,
yes,
take your reward from me.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right. Sheikh, you're right. Because why? When we pray the 5 times salat, before we pray the salat, we make the niyyah.
Yes.
That we are doing, performing the salat
yes,
for the sake of Allah.
Yes.
Right? For Allah.
Yes.
Right?
Allah.
And when we are fasting in the month of Ramadan, what we say, we are fasting for?
Yes. For Allah.
For Allah. That's right.
Yes.
So that's very important. Remember all the time about Allah.
Yeah, subhanAllah, it is very hard to stay hungry without eat and
yes,
without food, without drinking anything from morning till evening.
That's
just
right.
Just for people.
That's right.
Why for people? They will not give us anything.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
In our Islam, one of the best ahadith and good ahadith, Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes,
إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ.
Right.
The actions by intentions.
Intention,
okay?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
the actions by intentions.
Right.
وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَّا نَوَى. Everything you intend in your life,
yes,
you will get the reward as you intended.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
فَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Whoever migrated for Allah and His Messenger,
right,
his migration will be for Allah and His Messenger.
Right,
his intention
right,
was like this.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
And whoever migrated just for worldly things, for to marry someone,
right,
his intention will be for the same purpose.
Right.
He did.
Right.
At the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Sahaba, the companions, they were in Mecca,
right,
and the disbelievers, they punished them, they did everything bad with them.
Right.
Prophet Muhammad asked his companions to migrate from Mecca to Al-Madina.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Then all of them, they did that just to obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
Except for one man.
Yes.
He used to love one lady.
Yes.
And she said, if you want to marry me, you have to migrate to marry each other in Al-Madinah, not in Mecca here.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
And he accepted to do that.
Right.
He migrated. He
right,
left everything in Mecca.
Yes.
His wealth, his land, his house, everything in Mecca.
Yes.
And he went all this way just to marry that lady.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this hadith to tell us that all companions, they migrated for Allah and His Messenger except for that man.
Yes.
He migrated just to marry that lady.
Right.
That means he will not get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
I see. Okay.
We should take this example to put it in our life.
Okay.
When we do anything for Allah,
yes,
we will get the reward from Allah.
Right.
When we do it for people, for someone to say that I'm good, I'm bad, this and that,
right,
we will get our reward from that one.
Okay, but which can?
Yes, subhanAllah.
It's impossible.
Yes. Impossible, yes.
That's right.
Impossible, yes.
Okay. Well, that is was very enlightening.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, very enlightening. I'm sure many of our viewers will also be...
Yeah, we shouldn't lose our deeds.
Yes.
We
yes.
do a lot, alhamdulillah.
Yes.
But just put something which is do it for Allah.
That's right. So all the good, every that good deeds that we do, we say is for the sake of Allah.
That's it.
Right? To please Allah.
Yes.
We do everything for please Allah.
Yes.
Because on the day of judgment, this will be acknowledged by Allah.
Yes.
You did this good deed because of me.
Yes.
So you get rewarded for that.
Yes.
Right?
Just a small example before we finish.
Yes, yes, no problem. Please go in.
From my work in the masjid, I can see some people.
Yes.
One lady, she came to accept Islam. Why you like Islam? Why you accept Islam? Well, just I love that person.
Yes.
And he asked me to accept Islam before I marry him.
Ah,
it's not good like this.
It's not good.
It's not good like this.
Right.
Just accept Islam because you love Islam.
Because
you love Islam and you like Islam.
Right.
And you will get your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
Or you can see the opposite.
Right.
One boy, he accepted Islam just because he loves some woman or lady from Muslims,
right,
and he want to marry her.
Yes,
unless he can accept Islam, right. It's not good like this.
Okay, so in other words, if somebody becoming a Muslim because they're getting married, okay, that's fine.
That's,
they're getting
that's fine, but they should change
The primary reason should be that they love Allah.
That's it.
That's the first reason they become Muslim, and the second is of course to get married.
Yes,
alhamdulillah. Well, again, good piece of information, and keep watching. More information coming, because Imam is coming up with more topics for the new Muslims or for the who are not yet Muslim, who like to know about Islam. These are the information. Okay, we'll see you next week. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.